Thank you for listening to the Vincent Valentine Show. This show was broadcasted live on Barcelona City FM at Craft Barcelona. You can tune into the live broadcast at 9 p.m. Central European Time on BarcelonaCityFM.com.
Or you can watch the show live here in Barcelona. For tickets, visit poppyshop.com/events.
Tuned in to the Vincent Valentine Show on Barcelona City FM, broadcasting live from the heart of Barcelona with the funniest guests and a live studio audience. This is an adult show and may contain strong references to sex and drugs from the start and throughout the show. If you are easily offended, please switch off now.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Vincent Valentine Show.
Wow! Another great turnout. Thank you, Craft Barcelona, for having us here. This is the Vincent Valentine Show, and this is episode 9. And we have quite a few people here tonight. If you're going to stay here tonight, straight after our show, we have Stand Up Comedy Live with 5 amazing comics. And we have a guest host who's actually on the show with us tonight. He's called Chris Groves. Carry on.
Yeah, they can't see me, so just, you know, build it up a bit. You know, they don't know what I look like.
Well, let's describe what you look like. You're in your early 20s, you're very muscly, you're taller than me, and you've probably got a bigger penis than me.
Oh, well, that's indisputed. That's been proven on
You've never seen
occasions.
It?
I have, actually.
Have you?
Well, okay. I haven't seen mine for a while, but I've seen yours more than mine, probably, to be honest.
So Chris, tell us a bit about yourself.
Tell you a bit. You know, I'm a stand-up comedian, radio star, and a teacher, basically. That's my, you know.
A school teacher?
Sort of school teacher, yes. I mean, I'm a qualified school. Now I do a cat. Now I teach adults as much as possible because, you know, I had to be honest with you.
What type of education? Is it language, sex education?
English, yeah, it's okay, English. Yeah. It's English. You know, I can't teach anything else, to be honest. That's all I know.
So is it boring or is it... Happy. Oh no, sorry. If your employees are listening, yeah.
My employer. Yeah. I mean, no. My classes are highly recommended at €15 an hour. In fact, if any, are you all? Is everyone English speaking? Do I speak to the audience in this show?
Yeah,
here? Are you all English speakers?
I hope so.
Yes. Okay. Right. Okay. Now you just need to be English listeners. That's all you need to be tonight. You can shut up. So yeah. So I teach, but I kind of teach because nothing else gets me money, really. That's why.
So you don't get paid for comedy yet? Because I thought you were like professional level, aren't you?
I get paid. I get paid when I decide to pay myself. But yeah, you know, for a few years I was unemployed, and I lost my teaching job, and I was suddenly a comedian. That was it. I was for 4 years. I was just a comedian, which was which was very nice. I didn't have to say the teacher bit anymore.
That's good.
Being bad at your real career is actually a good move if you want to get into comedy or entertainment in any way.
Yeah. Our second guest is Rachel Arieff.
Hi, everybody.
I think they know who you are.
I don't know. I'm trying to check my Tinder down here, and this shit coverage.
I've switched the internet off exclusive for the radio show.
Yeah, this man has all the power down here in this little
only
hellhole.
For 1 hour. Only for 1 hour.
In the sewers of comedy.
Are you actually on Tinder?
Fuck yeah.
Okay. Do you have any Tinders people here? Any Tinder dates?
Everybody's.
Oh, she is.
Oh, there's a Tinder date.
Hello.
Oh, you're so.
I don't think she speaks English, by the looks of things.
I'm only on Tinder to have something look at when I'm on the toilet, honestly.
So you always swipe right?
It's fun, yeah, just swiping, 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 swiping on the toilet.
Sounds
you
understand? Good. Yeah, swipe
them
right.
Come on, Vincent, loosen up. You're a huge man.
I know, I'm
bigger
trying to
balls.
Listen.
His balls are bigger than his cock. Did you know that? I don't know that from sight. I know it from sound.
How does that sound?
That's what he said.
Yeah, that was that one drunken night we went out and.
Yeah, I'm not saying anything that you haven't said yourself.
No, it's fine. Yeah. I'm fine with my balls.
Yeah, you should be. Yeah. Every man and woman should be fine with their balls.
So you know what Rachel does here in Barcelona?
Talk about people's cocks in front of an audience of respectable Brits.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, Rachel runs a hugely successful anti-karaoke. Have you heard it? There we go. We've got a few fans.
Come on, motherfuckers! Say it louder if you heard about it. Yeah. I'm sorry. I hate to be so manipulative. Like, I won't do that again.
Do it again.
These people need more drinks. They've had a sad sack day at work.
Free drinks.
Free drinks.
Christopher, you're a drug dealer. Do you have any free drugs for these guys?
I've got sweets. Basically, I have a lot of sweets at home. I'll give you a sugar rush.
You can't offer these children sweets on the radio.
No, I've got my own children. I point out, I don't have sweets just for random children in the street. That would be completely inappropriate, and I'm not gonna have that broadcast.
Okay, sorry.
Vincent, how come you're the only one who's got light on you? Everyone else looks like shit on this stage.
I've actually forgotten to do that. You guys carry on talking and I'll sort out the lights for you.
Okay. Thanks. Well, okay, wow, I was just joking, but look at you. You're so accommodating. Look how tiny those tables are next to Vincent. They don't even reach his knee.
Ow, there you are. He's sorted that out.
This man
anyway.
Is suffering. I'm sorry.
Now Vincent does not have light either. That's fair.
I feel like
fair.
An asshole now for saying that. You know, these little IKEA stools, I need to steal one before I go home. Do you think they would notice? Because
I don't know.
I'm trying to make a couch out of pallets.
Ask him, could you rob him later?
That's a hip thing to do, right?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
I just ruined that light.
Yeah. I'm making a diaphragm for my uterus out of pallets that I found on the street. It's like really sustainable and just makes me feel like I'm part of something.
And I imagine very comfortable.
Thanks.
Very comfortable.
When I'm not talking about your balls, I'm talking about my
Is your quite big? Or?
It's gigantic. You know what it looks like? Jabba the Hutt. But like
whoa. We cannot say the C word. I just realized that.
But why not? I'm not calling someone a I'm not saying Vincent, you lunt.
That's more like it.
God, isn't that pathetic? Like, we're all adults. We can't say... We have to act like we're in kindergarten. It's not his fault, but...
It's 9 p.m. live. There's some children listening to this show, probably.
Well, you shouldn't have children in the first place if you're going to mess them up like that. If you're going to fuck up your kids' heads, keep your closed. And don't have children. Or be like me and steal a couple kids from the street in the Raval. There's so many cute little kids running around. They're adorable.
Okay, I live in Raval, actually. And I've been looking for my kids.
You're never going to have me back here again.
I'll offer you back. It depends on Daddy Jim if he has you back.
Jimmy.
Yeah, he's listening right now, by the way.
The reason I moved to Europe was to not have speech codes. And then I found out that when it comes to sex, you can talk about anything in Europe. But then, like, to say other things, you can't.
Yeah, the C word.
Or, like, talk about Hitler, you know, and none of it ever having happened. You know, you can't say that either.
You can.
But you can? You can?
Yeah.
All right, the Holocaust didn't happen.
Whoa, no.
What?
Right. No racism, remember. No hatred. And no C word, which you made me say.
Don't talk about Hitler's but talk about his balls.
That's fine.
Yeah.
His very Jew-friendly balls.
How many cunts were killed in the Holocaust? That didn't happen.
I am so sorry.
Zero! So therefore, I did not say the word.
This is going to probably be our last episode. I'm sorry.
Is it not on is it not like on a 10-second delay?
It's
live. It's 100% live. This is like going out to Barcelona City FM.
Vincent, you have a show that like the first thing you learn about it is a disclaimer. Like this show is highly offensive, and if you've got problems with please don't listen. And I know it's not your fault.
I'm sorry for
shutting down your show.
No, you're not shutting down my show. It's actually bringing more entertainment, isn't it? You like the C word.
The C word's very popular, C word,
I think they want to hear more of it during the... Yes. But I'm not going to say it anymore.
Okay, we need to think of another word.
Throwing the ball to you now.
That's fine.
Ball.
The C word, should we rename it something else?
No! That is so insulting to everybody's intelligence, you know? Like, you're so stupid, you wouldn't know that we were talking about a... If we were to say clunt.
That's it.
Or sklunt. That's insulting to every single adult here. Except for the station manager at Barcelona City FM, because he gave me my show too.
Yeah, no, you're on the radio.
It's not his fault. It's the world we live in. It's run by psychopaths. And they keep us under their thumb so they can do worse things than say, you know, certain words.
That's true, yes. They could.
Right. Talking about the first topic is political correctness.
Yeah, we're fed up with you and your political correctness. You just keep away from us.
You could say anything.
Let us say what we want.
You have the cutest accent in the world.
No one's ever said that to me before in my life.
It's like he could say anything. Say
I feel I should join in. I mean, anyone who hasn't said so far, so...
Fuck it.
Sorry, Vince. You define... Vincent, you define the question.
Will you please stop saying...
Yes, I will stop.
Okay.
Okay, that's done.
You
Sorry.
Want to talk about political correctness?
Yeah, because there's one of them. I went onto your website and I read some articles, and one of them was about political correctness. But you seem the least political correct, to be fair. Because every time I speak to you on the phone, you're so offensive, but in a polite way. Do you remember at the gym that time when I called you? When you were shouting, don't say the word.
Yeah. I was in the gym and I shouted
don't
something
say
else.
It.
No. Okay. No, I don't do comedy in English anymore. I do it in Spanish here. And I had a show called Coñólogos.
What does that mean? I don't know.
The cunt logs.
Oh.
And you did ask me. There, you did ask.
Does it? Is it that or is it not? So I had this story about how, it was a self-deprecating story about how typically puritanical and American chick I used to be in my first marriage. I have many of them. And how I reacted to finding my husband's porn on our computer in 2001. And I found, I went through, and this was like before videos, you know, so it was just like thumbnails. There was a site called Sublime Thumbs, and it was just his. So I was looking for this autopsy photo that I really enjoyed, because I'm American. We can't enjoy sex; we enjoy death. And I stumbled across my husband's porn trails, and I freaked out. I was so typical American chick, like, oh my God, I can't believe he does this. My world is shattered.
What was the search terms?
I looked at every single one of them, by the way.
Were the search terms?
It was so vanilla. It was like gangbang, lesbians, orgasm, like swingers. And then I found dogs.
Wow.
Yeah, so there was a picture of a dog and a woman. It was a picture of a dog, okay? Just say a dog fucking is what I found, okay?
Bestiality.
It was just, it was a dog, yeah. So... So I went around for days. I didn't talk to him about it. I was just like eating myself alive, thinking, what does a dog have that I don't have? And the answer is 8 more titties. So that was a joke. And then the next day, based on true events, which I think has its own merit. And then the next day, I get 2 emails. Anoche and Bart. And whenever you're a comedian and you get an email, last night in the venue you played, it's always they're enraged by something you did, and they're going to try to shut your career down, and they're really angry about something. So it was an animal rights activist, and she was extremely offended after hearing 2 hours of jokes about child abuse, racism, anti-Semitism, cruelty of all kinds. Then she got offended at this one joke about the dog having 8 more titties, and so. That got me thinking. Maybe it's the sex of the dog. Maybe I should change for next week the sex of the dog so that the dog is giving and not receiving. Oh, but then that would be offensive to feminists, you know? Because so then I asked the audience the next week which gender do they prefer for the dog to fuck?
And what was the answer?
It was 50-50, which is, I think it says good things about Catalans. You know, they're open-minded.
Yeah.
And the best thing about getting these 2 emails, they were these 2 different, I was praying that they had come together to the show, because if they didn't, this world is in a bad place. The best thing about these 2 emails was the fact that they got me to think for an entire day about which would be better to fuck, a male or a female dog. And if they hadn't sent me those letters, I never would have thought about it.
But everyone is so sensitive. I remember a few times I offend people on a daily basis. I can't help it. It's just me being British. Do you get the same?
I tend to be quite in my normal life. I'm fairly unoffensive. I tend to.
Yeah.
I'm a bit of a Jekyll and Hyde. I'm a teacher, so I can't really offend too many people.
True.
As a teacher. So I save it for when I get home, I guess, is really what I'm saying.
So you offend your wife?
Once I get home, then I can offend anyone I want, is what I feel I'm allowed to do.
I remember on the first episode I ever done on here, on this radio station, and we had our first complaint on the very, very first show.
Yeah.
Did you hear that? Yeah?
Yeah, because Jim told me about it.
It was super funny, but the question was, like, weird sex stories, and... His answer was, "I thought I got my mum pregnant," and it was kind of like, "Okay." And we did get a complaint for it. And what happened was, is this guy was like 13 years old, and he was masturbating for the first time in the bath. He ejaculated in the bath, and then his mum knocked on the door and said, "Like, I'm not going to say his name, but well, fuck it, Alistair, can I keep the water running, keep the watering. We're going to save the electricity and stuff." So. He was shitting himself so much that he thought that he would actually get his mum pregnant because of the bath water.
And it can't happen, or what? Are you
well, he's got a little brother now who's a bit...
Okay, because, you know...
He doesn't know that he's a father.
If that's not how my wife gets pregnant...
You know what? In America, that would be a heartwarming story.
It would be, yeah.
Yeah, because the mother brought the pregnancy to term, no matter what.
Well, he broke up the marriage because the father accused her of cheating.
Well, as long as a wonderful half-baby came out of it, then it's a good story for everybody.
So how long have you been doing comedy for?
I've been doing it quite a while. I've been doing it 5 years maybe now, six
five
years.
Wow.
Yes. Yeah.
So how did you actually get into comedy in the first place?
I started watching here. I used to go, I mean, I've always watched comedy, but I used to go to, there was a couple of places just around the corner from me in Laval that used to have, like, professional comedians over once a month. So I was like, I went to start watching this, and for some reason decided that I could do it. I guess it's, you know, they were comedians who travel tend to be, they were kind of on their way up, or on their way down. So they kind of get them in a weak moment, some of them, and it convinced me that I could do it. You know, so I persuaded this guy, who ran the venue, to let me have a go. I said I'd done it a bit before. I lied, obviously, through my teeth, and it was. The most horrible experience I've ever had in my life.
Did you bomb on the first?
I bombed majorly. Well, you know, because I was before a professional comedian, a room full of like 300 people probably, and just amazing ideas in my head of how funny I was going to be and how I was and I wasn't. You know,
it is soul destroying though, isn't it?
It's yeah, but you know, I got off and I. Just wanted to do it again, so that was it.
Yeah.
That's me, you know. Yeah. That's it.
So but the first time experiences, it's like, for me, no one understands me properly. So when I say a joke and everyone's looking at you like a dog does when you say something weird to it, that's why I don't do comedy anymore.
I was convinced that I could do this sort of reenact a scene between me and God, which was... It just didn't happen. Basically, I'm convinced it was a very funny scenario. I'm sure in the hands of an expert it would have been good. You know, as I spoke it, I could hear Eddie Izzard delivering it.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, it wasn't. It was me. That's the problem.
You guys, don't look at your Tinder right now. I could totally see you.
Yeah, she's on the Tinder.
She's checking. She's
Stop
checking.
It.
Hello.
She's checking. Who's God? She's
Bitch,
looking
at I'm talking to that guy on Tinder right now. How dare you? You want to go outside? You want to take it outside?
English. She doesn't speak English.
I was just looking at that guy in the bathroom earlier. Bitch.
Yeah, leave her alone. I will protect you. Don't worry. She's...
No. No, but thanks for asking.
So, Rachel.
Yes.
You were a comedian in L.A., was it?
I was a comedian in L.A. and in New York and Austin.
Yeah. And you were a professional, yeah?
I was a professional.
Yeah.
And I still am. But
not in English.
Not in English. I haven't done comedy in English in like 11 years.
And I've been trying so hard to get you to perform since I've known you. And it's just every month I'll just send you a nice little message like, do you want to perform? Do you want to perform? No. No, thank you. No, thank you.
It's weird. I just like doing comedy for Spanish audiences and for everybody tonight here. But I'm not doing it. They're looking at me like Stonehenge stones. Like, they're just like, oh, God. You look like Catalans, everybody. You're like this.
Uh-oh.
They need more drinks. Ooh, I'm so scared. Oh, my God. Oh, those Catalans, you do not want to get a Catalan person mad because they will send you silently such bad vibes. You know, like they'll shut their assholes really tight and it sends this breeze towards you, like toxic breeze. And if you have like 100 Catalans in one room, it can actually give you cancer like 5 years down the road. So you do not want to fuck with Catalans because they dangerous.
Super dangerous.
You know what I'm saying?
Catalans give you cancer.
Yes.
You heard it here first.
Visca Catalunya. Som un país.
But saying about Catalan before, I just
took my goddamn Catalan exam.
Exactly.
That's why I was late here.
Yeah, exactly. That's why you were late. That's why I was panicking. But yeah. How did the exam go? Did it go well?
I don't know.
What level of Catalan are you?
Only the Arab girls, I think, did well on the exam. You know, because they actually studied. Yeah.
You didn't study?
No, I did. I'm just retarded. I've been studying always. Yeah.
What level of Catalan are you? Beginners?
Intermediari. Sí. Serem amics, sisplau. Jordi.
Sisplau.
Jordi. Pau. Paul. Com es diu? Com et dius? See? I'm a fucking idiot. I don't even know how to talk to him. You're so cute. And your girlfriend. La teva noia. Marta, encantada. Soc una persona distinta fora de l'escenari. A l'escenari, soc un gilipollas. Sí, però catalanisme
Rachel.
Sorry.
This is an English show.
I'm sorry. Sorry.
Okay. Yeah, because
we've only got two
no
Catalans here right now.
I am so grateful for Catalans for letting me stay in their country for 12 years and not burning me alive like they did, like the Spanish did with my tribe about 500 years ago.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? The Catalans are fucking cool.
I like the Catalans. They're nice
they
people.
They have no self-esteem and they're passive aggressive, but they're so much nicer than Americans. They don't fucking come to your house and put a bullet through your fucking head.
Why?
They just send you bad vibes, and I can live with that. I love you.
We respect Catalans.
I'm on Tinder.
What's your username on Tinder?
Raquel. I forgot. It's Raquel. What am I? What
is
else am
it?
I gonna
is
be?
That it?
Raquel Catalan.
Soc en Pau. He calls himself En Pau. I don't understand.
No, I did comedy in Spanish as well, and I decided it'd be hilarious to pretend I was Catalan, you know, because Catalans are notoriously funny.
Does he look Catalan? Does he look Catalan to you guys?
I've been here 19, 20 years. I dress Catalan.
Do you speak?
I did the exam. I even passed an exam. But
he's a teacher.
I can't speak.
He's got that defeated look that Catalans have, you know?
I am defeated. I think the British and Catalans share traits of being defeated and depressed and
oppressed.
And
you know what I love about Catalans? That you celebrate your defeat September 11th, and they brag about it.
You celebrate
Own
terrorism.
It. No.
Okay.
No. 1714, motherfuckers.
What happened for all the radio listeners and me? You doesn't.
They
know
lost the
about.
War in 1714, and it's their big holiday.
So you lost the war and you celebrate it?
Yes.
Who did they lose against?
The Bourbons. Who was the war against? The Bourbons.
Spanish.
Oh my god damn it, motherfucker. What kind of Catalan are you? You don't even know who we lost the war to?
To be honest, I think they would say they lost the battle, but the war goes on. I think that's what they would
still
say
hate the Spanish. Catalans.
I love the Catalans. I love that someone else in the world is celebrating September 11th and they're like, yay!
But they don't know what they're celebrating.
They're celebrating their defeat.
Celebrating their defeat.
You know what? They own it. These people don't want to hear more about Catalans. Why are you looking at me like that?
I think he likes you.
I'll have him take my taburete home. You can
have
bring
you seen
it up
her on Tinder, by the way?
In the elevator.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm such a guarra. I hit on a phlebotomist at the hospital, Can Ruti, near Barcelona. My friend was getting an iron transfusion, and I totally hit on this kid who moves the beds around.
Yeah?
I'm such a piece of shit.
So let's talk about your anti-karaoke shows.
Okay.
Yeah, because the only reason I knew about you
Has anyone been there? Does everyone know what it is? Well, it's like a deformed karaoke show. But there's like a costume table, and you can get naked, and you can do all kinds of stuff on stage. And it's once a month, and now it's at the Moritz Brewery.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah,
cause yeah, and people fucking perform, and you know who performs better than anyone? Catalans. They do. They got some fucking nivel. You know what I mean? They got level.
See,
you guys have messed up my English. I don't even know.
Level.
They got. It's not about being good. It's about having confidence and not knowing what a fucking asshole you are while you're singing and owning it, like the Catalans own their September 11th.
No, it's a great show. I love karaoke, and I've been to your shows a few times when it was at Psychart before, and it was absolutely amazing. I'm yet to go to the Moritz.
Moritz is fun because it has actual bathrooms that aren't covered with shit and piss, and the doors lock, and you can steal toilet paper that's made of like exotic trees.
Is it the super toilet paper where it's about half a meter feet?
Yes, maybe? They have toilet paper bigger than all my babies that I aborted.
Okay.
And it's Moritz beer, but it's like fresh on tap. So, oh, I'm sorry to talk about someone else's beer. This is the best beer here.
No, Moritz beer is amazing. You ever been to a Moritz?
I have been to the Moritz, yeah. Not during one of the shows, unfortunately.
But the show, I mean, you can fit about 200 people down there, can't you? If not more.
Yes, we can fit 200 people there.
And
we're losing the crowd. Or is that the upstairs?
That's upstairs.
Let's ask upstairs. People what they want to talk. No, sorry, that's your thing.
Yeah. What do you want to talk about?
Catalans?
I'd like to repeat what she just said then. No. She said the C word.
You see? Everything see? Begins
it's
with a C.
What they want.
Catalans and
if the other public...
I didn't mean to point at you when I said that. I didn't mean that.
Are the
I meant
public like, allowed to say it?
I meant it like my big floppy thing hanging down. That's why the little bartender, the waiter kid won't come home with me.
Can the public say the C word?
Whatever they want.
Are they allowed? So if in conversation the C word is going to come up, can we just do that?
Yeah, they can do, yeah.
And they shout the C word and no one gets into trouble. They're anonymous.
The C word, yeah. Let's do it.
Can we do that? They can say it.
Do you want to do that?
Yeah, do you want to do that? Will you be our,
They don't fucking care. Let's just do it anyways.
Because no one's going to get, you can't get into trouble.
They are so violently indifferent.
I think this could work, man. So yeah, I would say, well, I don't know, you start. What stories do you want to hear?
Do you want to hear what his balls look like? They look like my if you inflated it with air. They're gigantic. It's like those things you see like floating in the air above the beach. The Hindenburg?
The Hindenburg, yeah.
Oh, wait, I'm messing up my...
You need to be more
I'm
circular.
I'm messing up my...
We need to get you some more drink, don't we?
Well, no, Vincent. Floating. You need to
Your balls float.
I wish they did, because I have to tie them up. I've got like a ball bra.
Okay. Because you could save a fortune on airfares if you had floaty balls. That would be amazing.
It'd be awesome, that. I wouldn't have to use a metro anymore, will I?
Vinny Airlines. You could just you could transport people backwards.
This nice lady named Marta, right? She thought I was insulting her.
Oh.
Because I said, bitch. And I wasn't. You see, in English, bitch is like, it's like punctuation. And
it's
I
like, it means hello. It means hello. Right. If you go to anybody here tonight and call and high five and go, bitch.
I want you.
They will love you.
I want you to call me a but with the microphone. I want you to, give her your microphone.
Don't call her a No, that's not nice. She's your girlfriend. Don't say that.
Say Rachel. Say, Rachel, you're a c***.
Rachel, you're a
c***. Yay!
You see?
Bisca Catalunya.
In that accent, it sounds much nicer, I have to say. It does sound... It sounds cool in that accent.
You're a ginger c***, by the looks of things. Are you ginger?
Oh, my God, thank you.
Okay.
No. My pubes are the color of, like... Every day in February, you know, you understand what I'm saying?
That could be a song.
Where are you from?
That could be a song. That is my pubes are the color.
What shitty city are you from in England?
I'm from Brighton.
That's the color of my pubes.
Ah.
Gray.
I'm really confused right now.
Every day is silent and gray. Like Rachel's pubes.
Oh, great.
Share. Okay. I'm too old for this audience.
Okay.
That was a Morrissey song from 1987.
Morrissey. Right. I've heard of Morrissey. They're just trying to picture your grey pubes and it's sounding a bit quiet. I feel it's what's happening.
Exactly. We're going to change the subject. We're going to have our first break. We have our first artist tonight. It's called Andrew Ripper from Norway. And he's got a really nice song. It's really uplifting. It's called Dear Suicide.
Yay! Suicide.
We'll be back in 5 minutes.
Friends and kin, put it on this other skin, held down by this demon wind. So let the show begin. They cannot see, they cannot feel this hiding fire. They cannot feel your voice webbing into my head, slipping endlessly, crawling whisper.
Andrew Ripper from Norway. That was really nice, actually, wasn't it? Nice and relaxed, super upbeat.
Yeah.
You don't want to kill yourself, do you? Masturbation.
It's a nice song. What do you guys think? How come the people in the far back are better lit than we are? That's
because
so fucked up.
That light broke.
It's annoying.
Bitch, she's lit up better than I am.
See, look at that. That's typical. You get when you got something you don't want
these,
it anymore. Look at
these
you.
These mics should be inalámbricos. These mics should be wireless, so we could just give the mics to those two.
We're dark.
Let's do it. Where are you from? Russia. That's why.
I'm not going to fuck with the Russian girl. I'm not going to fuck with the Russian
off.
Girl.
It's
I'm
all
afraid.
Blown off now. That's it.
Russian people are nice people.
I don't fuck with Russian girls or Puerto Ricans. What's that? That's what you say.
Oh, there you are. Good.
They're president.
Funny you should say that.
They're president.
Putin.
How would he feel about Donald Trump?
Oh.
You're an immigrant? Are you an emigre?
Yeah, but legal.
Legal.
I love the way
she's a legal immigrant.
As opposed to the rest of you, I feel, is what you're saying here, who are illegal, probably.
You do realize this is a live show and you just basically told...
But she's legal.
15,000 people live to the world that you're illegal. What's your full name?
No, she said she is legal.
Oh, she's legal.
Besbernik.
She's immortal.
You know what I love about you? My grandparents were Russian Jews, so it's possible that your great grandparents raped my great grandmother.
She's speechless.
What? I'm trying to make a connection.
We know
he's innocent. Is this can the anyone hear anything she's saying? Because
no
it's
one can
valuable.
Hear.
Oh,
no. Maybe okay. Next time.
Next time okay. We'll get a.
But there was somebody, some guy came up to the stage before and said something to you about Obama.
Yes,
what was
this guy named Trump. Dan Dan, yes. Dan. And by the way, he's Asian too. Just in case you didn't know, he's from Australia. And he wanted to know our opinions on Donald Trump. That's kind of like a softball, though, isn't it?
Yeah. I imagine Russians are really like thinking, my God, finally we're going to have a president who's a bigger asshole than they theirs. You know, people are going to be thinking Putin is kind of like a nice guy after that.
But
you know?
Putin gets the job done.
Yeah,
have you seen the
what
videos?
Job you want, really? But yeah.
No, it's like there was a video I saw on YouTube where there was this organization we were taking the piss. And he just literally went in there and went, look, I'm the daddy. Fuck you. Sign this paper now. If you don't sign it, you're going to die.
Did he say, I'm the daddy? That would be so funny if he actually
he probably
said,
did, yeah.
I'm the daddy.
It's anything you say is funny. He's like, did he say that I'm the daddy? That's just funny. You don't even need a punchline.
That's good.
Are you fascinated? Are you fascinated by the English accent of Christopher Groves?
Yes, I am.
I'm Catalan, really, so I'm putting it all on. But yeah,
English people make me feel like even more of a piece of shit than I really am, because they just seem like nicer people. Because of even you.
Even me, thank
you.
Yeah,
with your balls that are bigger than the Comarca de Girona. You're huge. Balls.
I love my balls.
Okay, you know what? I shouldn't talk anymore.
No, you can do. Carry on talking about balls. If it makes you happy.
I'm concerned about the audience. It's like there's this huge aisle. Although there are 5,000 people here.
No, there is 5,000.
It's a big room.
Why are you guys so far back?
No, they've gone up for a drink. They've gone for a drink upstairs. It takes forever to get served there.
They're coming back, look.
Well, yeah, but the survivors need to cover for the ones who are gone.
Do you see them 3 pints there?
They covered their drink up in case flies go into their drink. So that's very
or drugs.
Very professional. Oh, drug. Okay. Yeah.
I just love the people that didn't bring their mobile phone. Or were they don't have any coverage because they can't look at it during the show.
That's what I love about this
place.
That's
devastating to me.
It forces people to watch this show right now.
Or actually act like they are. I know the Catalans are watching it.
But she does not understand you whatsoever.
No, but Marta wanted to say something.
Oh, you...
Yeah, she's not stupid. She's not stupid like we are. Yeah, maybe she'll get really mad and we can have a real show. You know, sometimes...
She looks
Marta,
like...
que es la comedia. You know, a Catalan girl slapped me across the face and pushed a table into my ribs. One of the shows I did.
What, anti-karaoke?
No, a comedy show.
Ooh.
Look at it got all quiet. Yes, a Catalan girl hurt me physically. Isn't that great? Yes, it is. It shows that you can fight Almogavers. Oh, okay, I made a joke for only two people that understand.
Yeah, you need to stop singularizing these. Yeah, these two Catalans.
Look at the Catalans are smiling willingly.
And the rest of the audience are thinking like, we didn't come to Catalonia to learn this language.
An angel gets its wings.
What are you throwing Catalan at us for?
We've only been here. A kitten farts in heaven.
We've only been here 10 years. What do you expect us to know? Catalan as well?
Any of you Brits who are here that don't want to learn Catalan, go fuck yourselves.
anyone speak Catalan here, by the way, apart from the Catalans?
The drunk guy who's like drinking, he's like, yeah, yo también. Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
It's a beautiful, I will say it's a beautiful language. It is a beautiful language.
No, it's not. It's ugly as fuck.
It's not. I'll just give him something, you know.
I'm only learning Catalan to tell people that they're wrong in their own language.
Exactly.
You know what? This is how self-destructive I am. This place is like 90% Anglo and two Catalans. And who do I pander to? Whose ass do I lick? The Catalans.
Exactly.
And then like I insult 99% of everybody else. But they're Brits. They're so drunk they can't even
move
anywhere.
Well, they're not Brits. I mean, is there any British people here tonight? One, two. Americans? Raise your hand.
Hi.
Spanish.
Russian. These.
Yeah. So, yeah, we got a mixed bag here tonight.
The Australian guy's disappointed because we never answered his question about Donald Trump. What else does this say about Donald Trump?
It's boring, though, isn't it?
Is anybody surprised that he's going to get the nomination?
I would like. Firstly, the name. I feel there's a gap for Trump Trumps. Yeah. Do you know Top Trumps? Do you have the card, the Top Trump cards, where you have like statistics?
I think that's when the world was in black and white, Chris.
There's Barbie Top Trumps, and I've got all these things for my kids. Top Trump, no one knows. There's like cards, and you get like statistics and points, and you choose the best one. I think Trumps would be quite cool. Just
your
the most stupid
is
things
too
he's said.
Smart for me. I don't know what you're saying.
But you know the word Trump. In English, you know what it actually means, do you?
Yeah, I know.
Means to pass when.
To like, vencer.
We speak English. This is an English show.
I know, but I can't anymore because I've been drinking this beer. The Australian guy who's Asian from Vietnam, he's disappointed because he wanted us to make racist jokes about Asians and we're not going to do that. See? His name is Dan Dan. And it's really not, but he said it sounded more Asian. So he said, call me Dan Dan. But there's nothing bad to say.
You're giving a green pass, but in fact, were you given a green pass as well or not? Or did you? You're giving it to us, but did Australia give you a green pass or not? Did you?
The Australian culture.
Okay. Yeah, Australia. Well, I must say.
Yeah. So you're not illegal?
I think...
No, he's winking at me. He's like, don't say that word.
You're very cool, but a lot of the Australian white guys that I've met are very racist. Do you think so? You think this guy thinks so?
I'm from New Zealand, so I...
He definitely thinks so. I think they're racist, and they have five legs, and they eat their grandmothers. That's what he thinks about Australians.
I hooked up with this psycho pilot from New Zealand while I was still married. And, wait, did I say that out loud?
No, you're just carrying talk.
Anyways, nothing. I like New Zealand. I'd like to go there sometime.
No, you carry on.
I think all pilots are crazy.
Are you crazy?
No, I'm just drunk. This guy from New Zealand, how come you don't have a funny accent?
What do you mean? I don't know.
Oh, now he does.
Yeah, now he does.
He's like, woo.
So... We're getting to the end of the show.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Rachel's already plugged in her anti-karaoke. When is your next show with anti-karaoke?
Thank you, Vincent, for being professional. It's Saturday, June 11th at Moritz Brewery, which is on Ronda San Antonio, where you can see the putas chinas. You know what I mean? Those Chinese ladies who are doing what I'll be doing in a couple hours.
Okay.
They, yes, that's where the, they're very nice ladies and we're very good friends. The Anti-Karaoke is in Fabrica Moritz, Saturday, June 11th.
And how much is it? Oh, is it a free event? Is it?
Fuck no, it's not free.
Okay.
What do you want me to suck cock every night of the week in Ronda San Antonio? No, it's 10 euros and it comes with a free Moritz.
Cool.
And toilet paper, all you can steal.
Super good. And then how? It's on for a few hours, yeah?
Yes, it starts at 10 p.m. But if you know the band Coyote and the Lip, they're going to be playing from 9 to 10. So, excuse me, it's Coyote and the Lip and Anti-Karaoke in Fabrica Moritz. Coyote and the Lip is this great blues band of two Americans, one from San Francisco, one from New Orleans. Real authentic blues, and they're the shit. So please come out.
No, that sounds pretty good, actually. Chris, you got no shows this weekend, have you?
I've got no shows this weekend. I'm having a weekend. Well, I'm going to do some stuff in Spanish this weekend, hopefully.
Yeah.
I run a couple of guys. There's a every month here. There's a show here that I run called Barcelona Comedy Club in English, and that's €5. And we have shows here every month, so keep an eye out for that. And then I do shows as well in a bar called Las Cuevas del Sorte on Calle Gigas number 2, and we do comedy there every weekend. Apart from this weekend, every Friday we have an open mic, and every Saturday we have other shows doing different shows. So. That's it. They're free to get in. I will say no more than that.
Catalan friendly.
They're free to get in. It's Catalan Catalan friendly. Yes, they are Catalan friendly.
What does that mean?
It means they don't like spending money.
No.
Look, that's what he gets offended by. That's weird, isn't it? You know, all the things that have been said.
Catalans are proud of how cheap they are. They always brag about it.
Yeah.
Tú pagas un fuet y ya está.
Will you please speak English? We're
on
an English show.
You pay a sausage and you're in. It's not funny. No one laughs. So I'm talking
exactly.
To the... At least the Catalans laugh at me.
These two guys here are not for the radio. It was
these
like,
are
this
my
is
people.
For like English speaking audience.
I know.
There may be. I don't want to blow your mind. There may be one or two Catalans in Barcelona as well, Vinny. I don't know. I'm not sure. They may have slipped through. You know, we do try and keep them out, but they may get in.
No. You know who my people are?
Go on.
Catalans, Kiwis, and
you said it again. That's it.
But
don't
no.
Say You're Kiwis. Welcome. Do not say Kiwis on air. How many times have you been told?
They said do not say Kiwis, that word.
That Kiwis is
that
fine.
Word.
There's nothing wrong with Kiwis. But apart
right,
from
Kiwis
that,
are cunts, to be honest. I don't know. That.
So there's no... There's
oh, they meant krauts.
Krauts.
What's going on right now?
We didn't do the racism bit.
The
so
Vietnamese guy is still disappointed because we never insulted him directly.
I think the cookie's still in my blood right now because I'm really confused. But anyway, next week, this is episode 9, episode 10 of the
if
show.
There is a next week.
I'm going to turn off your mic. 1 minute.
Good night, everyone.
All right.
Mine's still on. Mine's still on.
On. This is our 9th show today. I've turned both your mics off now. Burp in my face. I can smell semen. But yeah. Apart from that, you can have your microphone back now. There you go, Rachel. So there's no other events that you're doing
you're going
apart
to Manchester,
from
yeah? Manchester.
It's in Manchester.
No Catalans in Manchester is what
I'm
he's saying basically.
No,
Catalan
Isaac went to Manchester. But yeah. He's not listening now, yeah.
I do have some other thing. It might not seem relevant, but I am writing a book on familial abuse, so enjoy that too. It'll be coming out soon.
Are you actually writing a book?
Yes.
Is it in English?
Yes. No. Sorry, no.
You had the wrong guess for this. It's like, but no, it's like.
I'm an immigrant.
But the thing is, right? She's being polite. She's fueling your.
She's not being polite. She's a fan of my semen breath and your huge balls and his cute accent. Thank you.
I would rather have semen breath, to be honest with anyone.
It could have been you, Chris, actually.
What, the semen breath?
Yeah.
It could be, because I'm fairly flexible, is all I'm saying. I'm able to get down there, is what I'm saying.
No one wants to imagine
no
that.
No one else is, but I can get reach mine.
But no.
They all are imagining it now. Me in my bathroom, testing my flexibility.
But no, it's been an honour to have you.
That fucking time you showed up.
I know. They're here for the stand-up comedy live, which you're not performing, which I asked you to.
No.
I know. But go maybe on. You could go on.
I only perform in Catalan.
Go on. Do five minutes in Catalan.
No, no, not right now. We are live. We only have 9 minutes before we finish. But no, in all seriousness, it's like he does some really big Spanish shows here. You should get on one of his shows and do Spanish comedy.
I don't understand what you're saying. Speak English.
I am speaking English.
What are you saying?
Okay.
Sorry.
I said, as you only do comedy in Spanish, why don't you do one of Chris's shows, which is in Spanish comedy? Are you that drunk?
No, I'm not. Fuck you.
In fairness, I should probably be begging to go on one of her shows. Yeah, I feel her audiences are probably.
In fairness, he never asked me to be on his show, so don't put him on the spot.
No, you know. If I ran
good.
Maybe you
she
did ask
good.
Me.
I've seen some
you.
Of her English stuff on YouTube, and she is really good. That's why I'm gutted that she will never do English comedy again.
Who's performing tonight?
Chris is actually going to be the host.
Yes,
we've got Rudy. So straight after this show, in 15 minutes, you're going to be hosting Stand Up Comedy Live as our guest host, and we've got five other comics. And
go
Rachel
wild.
Would have been on there if she would have said yes to tonight, but she doesn't want to perform in English.
It's too painful for me. I have nothing to say to Americans, except those two there. And fuck Donald Trump, and please, I hope you registered to vote. Bernie Sanders. 2016.
It's not going
to
happen, though, is it?
Democrats
really?
Abroad.
Who?
Yes, it will!
Bernie Sanders. He actually looks a bit like you.
Bernie Sanders. Okay. So you got Trump or Sanders. That's right.
Did you hear what you just said? I don't know who that was more insulting to.
No, he does. Chris Groves does look a bit Bernie Sanders.
Okay.
Have you seen it? You know what it looks like?
I only know Colonel Sanders. That's the only one I know, unfortunately.
You know the word
Berguenza, I can so Bernie. I don't know who Bernie. So I have kids. I have no idea what happens in the world.
If he became president, the world would be saved. But it's just
how come people who have kids are the people who are least justified in having kids? He says, "I have kids, therefore I know nothing about what happens in the world." Why'd you bring your kids into this world?
To talk.
Your wife should have shut her.
She did. Yes. Why? Applause for my wife shutting up. That's
how
that's possibly the most cool applause I've ever had there. That's
how long have you been married for, by the way?
I'm not actually married, funnily enough, but I call her my wife because we have the misery, so, you know.
You have the misery.
Yes, we've been together. Been together 19 years.
19 years and you're still not married?
20 years, yeah, you know. We do think about it occasionally because you get 2 weeks holiday in Catalonia for getting married, so it's tempting.
So why don't you get married?
Why don't we get married?
Yeah, exactly. If you got
just to time it, you got to get the right time. You can't it can't coincide with holidays, otherwise you lose a day. You got to get it in the right time. I'm sorry, if you get married.
Do you have any kids, Rachel?
Not anymore. I mean, I had like five abortions. You know, why? What's wrong with that? You guys have a nativity scene with a guy shitting next to the baby Jesus. You can't say having five abortions is wrong. That's the pot calling the kettle black.
She's just
do you know
lost
what
the
I mean?
Audience.
Mentens? No, I didn't. I have the audience. They're fucking silent. They want to know more. The first one would have been half black. The second one half Asian from Australia. Dan is the father of one of my aborted children. Okay? This New Zealander is the other one. He's a pilot. And this guy looking at me like all judgmental, he has to do that because it's a cover because he's the fourth father. And Vincent Valentine has those huge balls. He gave me two twins that I got rid of.
Was that you?
Yeah, and I am his mother, and I'm the one who took the bath. And that's what you call a perfect tie-up.
Perfect tie-up to an end of episode 9.
I hope you can broadcast this show somewhere.
Well, it is being broadcasted right now, actually.
He said it was on YouPorn.
It's on YouTube, YouPorn, Barcelona, City FM, you name it. The whole
it's
world
on
is
YouTube.
Listening right now.
There we are.
But first off, I would like to thank Barcelona City FM for allowing us to broadcast live.
Thank you, Barcelona City FM.
Live.
This is probably going to be the last live show we're going to be doing.
Yeah,
I can smell it again. Second place we want to thank is Craft Barcelona for allowing us to be downstairs.
Yay, Craft Barcelona!
Big round of applause for Craft. Yay!
And thirdly, our guests, Rachel Arieff and Christopher Groves, thank you for being a guest in this week's show.
Yay, Christopher!
Oh, yay! Big round of applause for us.
In about 15 minutes, we're going to start Stand Up Comedy Live, so grab a drink, go to the toilet, and come back and see you in 15
but
minutes.
An applause for the audience, too.
That's what I was going to ask now.
You should always lick the audience.
You just... That was what I was going to do just then. Anyway, let me just recap. Thank you guys for coming. This is what I was going to do. Thank you guys for coming. We'll see you next week, hopefully, or in 15 minutes. This is the end of the Vincent Valentine Show. Good night.
Good night. Whoa!
I shall go fight right. I got some yummy tea. The fight toast to a faulty. Do you even know? I forget. Hey, could not you share all this dear boy? There was so many teams. I really see that. Master team.
Skulle möta.